So, good morning, everybody. Good morning, Alice. Right, okay, nearly the longest day of the year. It is Saturday the 20th of June, 2015, 06:33 hours, British summer time. Although it's grey, it's overcast. It's a little bit chilly, but it's not too bad. There is rain forecast. Did I say that twice? I can't remember. I'm probably losing it. Anyway, Cardiff today, maybe doing a quick tech Saturday, maybe not. There will be beer involved. I'm in training for Flanders, not Ned Flanders, the actual players. Countdown has begun. You can't go to Belgium, in which Flanders is located, without being trained for the high quality ales and the strong ales. Trappist, here I come. Anyway, that's it for now. See you later. So, this is the first time I've ever seen this platform used. Apparently, there are no trains between Estremunnock and Rumney, and this bus is replacing them. So this has been used. Still grey. No sign of my train. And this is the 7:25. Well, apparently mine's on time. Anyway, I'm going in the direction of the grey, that way. So, Cardiff. And it's greyer. And it's breezy. Still not too cold, but it's breezy. I might just have a long way round. I need to go that way. But I'll probably go via Jessops. I thought they went past. Ooh, cider festival. £2.15 a pint. Not quite there yet. However. And we're off. Number one. Bateman Gold. From Bateman's. Who knew? 3.9% alcohol by volume. Chinook. I can't remember what the other hops were. But I'm thinking lemony. It does actually say lemony on the pump clip. Bit of carpet for Mr. Manning. Ooh, does smell citrusy and fruity. In fact, that's highly lemony. I think you have to ask yourself, do you like lemony beers? I do. And the finish goes on quite a long way. It is bitter. Anyway, get on with it and speak plus plus. Number two, and I've dropped into out of the fridge mode. Anchor Steam Beer from San Francisco. Imported, 4.8% alcohol by volume. I might have had this a long, long, long time ago, i.e. before Untapped in Birmingham. Not much of an aroma. I'm not sure. It may be too cold to taste. It's okay, it's B plus, but I'll reserve full judgment for when it warms up a bit. Nice bit of finish. So with this one, there's no ambiguity. This is a Pilsner, which I brewed just above freezing and tastes good straight out of the fridge because that's what they're designed to do. 4.8% alcohol by volume. There's a trend here. Anyway, slightly grosh shaped bottle enclosure. It's a B plus. It's a proper Pilsner. It's rather bitter. It's very bitter, which a Pilsner should be. Oh, this is doing wonders for my uniques. Ooh, barrels. To sit on. And ales. And there's Twitter. Who knows? New. And gone. Possibly a YouTube takedown. Due to the Led Zeppelin brothers. Fine ales. This is Slap Mustic. It's Belgian. Blonde. 6.4%. As I'm going, I'm drinking. Smells fruity. Ooh. Strong and good. B++. Lovely. Okay. I'm a Beaverton Virgin. This is a Blood Orange IPA. 7.2% alcohol by volume. I've had a sniff. It smells lovely. And here's Jimi Hendrix. We are recharging at the moment. So okay, I haven't tried this before. Oh wow. A.
It's also depends on what criteria you use.
Really.
That's basics in the 70s.
Sudden death, what's a beat? And it's sour. Creek. Cherry. Okay, I'm looking. 4.5% alcohol by volume. Not the best creek ever, but B++. Dorothy's. Van Halen in Cardiff.